नहीं नजर आता है क्योंकि ही इज बिजी डूइंग द वर्क. रत्ना
आई जस्ट कॉल्ड अमित आपको फाइंड आउट है हमारा भी रहना होता है ध्यान दे रहा है पर्सनल ये बात तो मतलब फिलोसॉफिकल डिबेट है.
डिस्पाइट ऑल दैट अरे ये प्रैक्टिकलिटी की है क्यों देख रहे हैं.
Oh, you want us to get
it? You want the girl?
Vinita!
They're gone with the water! Very nice people!
Thank you.
You
have to
get your hand. I'm
That's more important. Hi,
Sankar.
Hi. Yeah. Nice. I'm with my students.
Oh, very good. Excellent. Very good. Troubled waters. We're going to request our trustee Ratna ji to inaugurate this. But before we do that, maybe 1 minute from Silva on your exhibition.
Yeah. Life in Troubled Waters, my long-term project.
A bit so, louder, I think.
Yeah, it's a long-term project. So here, like, we plan, like, there are three sub-stories which talks about fisherman issues. And the rest of the picture is talks about the general lifestyle and some general issues which they are facing. That's the way we planned that exhibition. I'm very much thankful to that NFI because this is my long-term project which has got funding and to work for a year. Thank you so much for the NFI. So that's
thank you. And we can have a look at the pictures and then we'll move to the amphitheatre. Ratna ji.
This story is talking about the erosion. This is in Mangalore, Karnataka. This is a school actually. Which partially erupted during the time of the cyclone in Chennai. This is again this place called Yenmi. Here it's that sea is very close and it's almost like partially closes. That's a solution that is not scientifically proven. The sea wall is stopping the erosion. So to stop these kind of sea erosion, usually the stones are like under. To stop the waves to come in. So they extract the area. This is in Mangalore, Milan. It's a high
erosion.
So even if you put the stones, it's still it's eroding the houses. That's the idea. Thermal plant. So usually they have the waste of the fly ash. So they dump. Usually they, now they are saying they are not dumping it, but usually they dump in the sea. So which affects the land. So the boat.
because now there is a river mode which is getting violent. So last past 2 years these people are offering some puja. So they believe that calm down the river. This is what I told, like, this is much the catch we got after like 6 hours of meeting.
It's already done. National Foundation for India's 17th Annual Media Fellowship and C. Subramaniam Awards Ceremony. At the outset, let me thank you all for making time to be a part of the event. I'd like to thank Mr. Harsh Mandar, Ms. Shoma Chaudhary, and Sandeep Dixit for agreeing to join us this evening. I'd like to invite Ms. Varsha Polija, Director of Programs, NFI, to welcome and introduce our honored speakers and also say a couple of words on NFI.
Thank you, Mini. The National Foundation for India, or NFI, is an independent Indian grant-making and fundraising body helping people to improve their own lives. We make a difference by supporting partners who look for solutions for complex problems in poor, remote and challenging parts of the country. NFI's distinct nature comes from being completely independent of corporate, religious or governmental control and having a nationwide focus. The foundation was set up in 1992 as a professionally managed grant-making organization with a mission to help create a just and equitable society. And since then, it has been guided by eminent Indians like Dr. Swaminathan, C. Subramaniam, Dr. Kamala Chaudhary, Ratan Tata, S.P. Godrej, Deepak Parikh, Manmohan Singh, Kiran Karnik, to just name a few. This year is the 19th year, and NFI till date has awarded around 400 fellowships and disbursed close to 40 crores to over 280 partner organizations in projects spanning 7 thematic areas. These are community health, citizens and society, peace and justice, livelihood security, strengthening local governance, elementary education, and development journalism. By funding cutting-edge development projects, NFI assists in institution building to strengthen the voluntary sector, supports initiatives that are community-based and driven, and catalyzes youth action and active citizenship, and helps in the transmission of valuable knowledge to enhance public understanding. This evening, we have the pleasure in welcoming you to the National Media and C. Subramaniam Award Ceremony, followed by a conversation on media, leadership and social change beyond Arab Spring and Anna Movement. The honored speakers are Shri Sandeep Dixit, Member of Parliament, Shoma Chaudhary, Managing Editor, Tehelka, and Shri Harsh Mandar, Member, National Advisory Council. The interaction will be moderated by Shri Amitabh Bihar, Executive Director, National Foundation for India. May I now request Mini to take over?
Thank you, Varsha. The Social Leadership Award Fellowship Program was instituted in 2003 in honor of the founder chairman of NFI, late C. Subramaniam. It was under his leadership that NFI was conceived and made operational. The program is meant for mid-career voluntary sector workers and community leaders engaged in constructive work and struggles for justice in their communities. The program enables grassroots voluntary sector workers and leaders to come together and share their experiences in a self-critical manner. A cash reward of Rs 50,000 is given to each of the fellow. I'd like to request Mr. Pankaj Bhutalia to say a few words about the C. Subramaniam Awards. Pankaj is a renowned documentary filmmaker. His sensitivity and empathy for the grassroots leadership has made him a part of the C. Subramaniam Fellowship Selection Jury for many years now. Pankaj, please join me on stage to share your thoughts on the fellowship program.
Thank you, Mini. Well, you've given the basically C. Subramaniam Fellowship for mid-career voluntary sector workers, community leaders, for promoting voluntary activities and local leadership in the fields of food security and sustainable livelihood. Now, I've been on the jury of this a few times, and the first time when I was asked to be on the jury, I actually found that I said that the amount that you're giving, the Rs 50,000, seems to be very small. But that is what the NFI was putting out that time. And it is surprising to find that even for this 50,000 rupees, there were a very large number of people who used to apply regularly. So in the first set of interviews, one of the first questions we asked them was, especially to some of the people who had been working for 15 to 20 years, was that, why do you feel this reward, this award can actually help you? Why do you feel motivated to come and ask for this? And it was very interesting to get the answer. It was not for the money, because the money could not sustain them beyond a very small period. But they felt that this award was finally a recognition for the kind of work that they've been doing for a very, very long time. And all those of us who are familiar with the kind of work that goes on in the areas which are not mainstream will recognize that the very marginality of the nature of the work, nevertheless, the great importance of the work, makes it a strange paradox, because on the one hand, it's a great motivation for those people who want to get involved in such work. On the other hand, it's a very lonely struggle. Most of the time, there is hardly any support, either financial or otherwise. People around them also rubbish them. People from within the family say, what is this kind of work you're doing? This is not the kind of work which you're getting anywhere. This is not the kind of work which you get financial rewards. And somehow, they manage to carry on. They carry on over time. So something like the C. Subramaniam Award actually, for them, is a very, very big thing to hold on to, because it is, in a sense, a very important acknowledgement of the fact that they have been actually working for 15 to 20 years. Because this award is meant for mid-career workers and not for people who are starting off or people who have achieved a lot. For people who are, in a sense, you know, somewhere in between, so that their desire to carry on can be somehow strengthened. And it is this which you know, made me want to come back again and again, talk to a large number of people who have come. Of course, we meet ultimately a very small number of people who are from the number of total applicants, because there is a shortlisting done by the members of the National Foundation. And after that, we are asked to interview, first look at and then interview a fewer number. But every time you meet people, it becomes so difficult to choose, because almost every individual is showing such tremendous strength, such tremendous motivation, and against all odds, that you feel like actually not wanting to choose, wanting to give an award to almost every single person who comes. So in a sense, I think that this very small gesture is something that is so significant, because it is one of the few recognitions that is made in public life of the fact that people work in areas where nobody dares to work. There could be people working in the tea estates for tea plantation workers. Now, where have you ever thought of tea plantations workers having any kind of support to be able to take forward any minimal agenda also? We know the conditions under which tea plantations work most of the time, and for how long. I mean, it's like a form of bonded labor for God knows generations. But to find people there getting motivated to form some kind of a body which could at least take up some basic health issues, if nothing else, and to be able to struggle for some of the very, very minor issues which contemporary trade unions take for granted all the time, is very, very, you know, heartening to find that somebody is actually doing this. And it actually cuts across gender. You will find, you know, isolated women working in, you know, complete corners of this country. You'll find people who are in the heart of Delhi. You'll find people who are working for Dalit causes. You'll find people who are working for gender issues, health issues, for childcare. So I mean, there's such a range of people who are working on a whole range of issues that I think that this little gesture that the NFI makes is one of the most important, you know, recognitions that it has for the kind of work that is its basic objective. And on behalf of the other people who've been on this panel with me now and in the past, I can only say thank you very much to the NFI for allowing me to undergo this experience of meeting a large number of people who I would not have otherwise met. Thanks.
I'd like to request Ms. Ratna Sudarshan to join me to give away the awards to this year's C. Subramaniam Fellows. May I request the C. Subramaniam Fellows to come on the stage to receive their awards as and when their names are announced. Uma.